Hold on a minute, because I got to have a quorum. Yes. Yes. Yeah, I'm ready. Yes, and good evening, and thank you all so much for joining us this afternoon for our Williamsburg County Council regularly scheduled meeting. We do have a public hearing, which will begin at 5:45 this afternoon, and we're running just a few minutes behind, so please accept our apologies. The purpose of the public hearing is for the public to become acquainted with a proposed rural development project. Williamsburg County intends to submit an application for a loan/grant through the United States Department of Agriculture, USDA, Rural Development Community Facilities to provide funding for the proposed project. Information will be provided regarding the proposed community facilities project. Said project is proposed to include renovations to the Alex Chapman Complex and Auditorium. Citizens will have the opportunity to comment on the proposed grant application and consider topics such as economic and environmental impacts, service area, and alternatives to the project. Projects funded by rural development are equal opportunity programs, and discrimination in the program is prohibited by federal law. And so that is the purpose of our public hearing. And so the floor is open for anyone who wishes to comment on this particular issue. Thank you so much.
Is that on that proposal, and I just wanted to come here today to show my support in the initiative. I think it's a positive initiative currently where we are working out of. We have a lot of different issues in that building. The building is extremely old. There are a lot of safety concerns, so it's just not cosmetic upgrades that will be done if we were to pursue this initiative. So some examples, just really quick, the windows don't open. We don't have certain things in place for if there were a fire for us to safely be able to exit our building. So again, just to be short, the initiative I think is a positive one where a lot of different upgrades can not only be done to our section of the complex, but other different departments as well. So,
right. Very good. Thank you so much.
I'm DeAndra Cooper.
Thank you, Ms. Cooper. Thank you. for the public hearing. Thank you all so much for your attendance, and we also thank you all for the comments at the public hearing. This is our regularly scheduled county council meeting, and it is now time to call it to order. We're going to ask Councilwoman Hales if she would please lead us with the invocation this evening. Councilwoman Hales.
Thank you, Mr. Supervisor. Let us pray. Our precious Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Lord, we come before you this evening, thanking and praising you, God, for another council meeting that you have allowed us to come together and be about the county's business.
Yes, yes, yes.
Lord, we ask you for your wisdom and your guidance to lead us, O God, as we make decisions this night.
Oh, yes.
And we ask you also, God, that you will bless each and everyone in attendance this evening. Let us not forget about the sick, the shut-in, and the bereaved families of this community, Lord. And we also pray for traveling mercy as we return home. These and all other blessings we pray for in your precious name. And let every heart say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Beautiful. Thank you so much. At this time, I entertain a motion to accept the approval of the minutes from the September 11th special called meeting. Is there a motion to accept the approval of minutes?
No move, Mr. Chair.
We have a motion by Councilman Floyd. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a second by Councilman Wilson. Are we ready for questions? All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The motion has been carried. All right. Ordinances this evening. First reading of ordinance number 2023-12, an ordinance to adopt the 2023 multi-jurisdictional Williamsburg County Hazard Mitigation Plan to promote the public health, safety, and general welfare of the citizens of Williamsburg County. This is the first reading of this ordinance. Again, ordinance number 2023-12. Is there a motion to move on this ordinance?
So moved, Mr. Chair.
All right. So we have a motion by Councilman Floyd. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Councilwoman Hales. Are we ready for questions? All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion has been carried. We have a second reading of ordinance number 2023-11, an ordinance authorizing amendments to a fee in lieu of ad valorem taxes agreement and an infrastructure credit agreement by and between Williamsburg County, South Carolina, and a company currently identified as Project Extract to include an expansion project under said agreements and extend the terms of certain infrastructure credits thereunder, approving a county economic development grant for Project Extract and a performance agreement governing the terms of such grant and addressing other matters related thereto. Is there a motion to accept second reading of ordinance number 2023-11?
So moved, Miller.
We have a motion by Councilman Miller. Is there a second? We have a second by Councilman Lee. Are we ready for questions? All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The motion has been carried. There are no ordinances for third reading this evening. There are no ordinances for third reading. As it relates to the committee report, the bid committee, I'm going to ask that we table this particular issue until the next council meeting. I think it would be in council's best interest to have the water superintendent here to answer any questions that the members of council might have, okay? So I'd like for us to just table this until the next meeting. All right. Is that an action item? All right. So is there a motion to table this to the next meeting?
So moved, Miller.
We have a motion by Councilman Miller to table to the next meeting. Is there a second?
Second.
We have a second by Councilman Wilson. Are we ready for questions? All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right. Motion has been carried. All right. We have an executive session According to Section 30-4-70A1, an executive session to discuss personnel requests from the treasurer, clerk of court, and the auditor. Is there a motion to go into executive session?
So moved.
Motion by Councilman Wilson to go into executive session. Is there a second?
Second.
A second by Councilman Lee. Are we ready for questions? All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, we will be in executive session. All right, we're back. Listen, thank you all so much for your patience. Is there a motion to come out of executive session? There were a motion by Councilman Lee to come out of executive session. Is there a second?
Second.
A second by Councilman Wilson. Are we ready for questions? All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion is carried to come out of executive session. There were no decisions made in executive session. It was discussion only. Discussion only. All right. County supervisors report. I've got just a couple of things that I need to make the public aware of. There's a boil water notice that's still in effect for the residents of the Martin Luther King Jr. and Sandhurst Road area. We had a water break there last week, and we've repaired the water leak. But before we can lift the boil water notice, we have to have two good water samples. And at this point, they have to be consecutive. And so we have not had two consecutive good water samples yet. So as soon as we get that, get those two consecutive water samples, we will lift the boil water notice for that area. We apologize to the residents of that area for any inconvenience that this may have caused you all. Secondly, our office has received quite a few phone calls about mosquitoes in certain areas of the county. About 4 years ago, under the former administration, this county council voted to give certain responsibilities to the sheriff's office. One of those responsibilities was the spraying for mosquitoes. And so that responsibility does not come under the supervisor's office. It comes under the sheriff's office. And so I would ask that you reach out to the sheriff's office, or if you still want to call us, that's fine, and we will send the information over to the sheriff's office. But Sheriff Gardner and his staff are responsible for the spraying of mosquitoes. Our county council earlier in the year did town hall meetings in each one of the seven council districts. And during that time, we discussed doing those kinds of meetings twice a year. And so as we enter into the fall, we're going to be meeting with the members of council and discuss having those meetings again. We'll be posting something very, very soon as to where we will be having those meetings at and the dates, the locations, and the times of those town hall meetings. I thought that it was very good for myself and the members of council to get into the communities, go out and meet with the residents of this county and ask questions and give them an opportunity, answer questions, and give them an opportunity to make comments and to ask whatever questions that they might have. Everybody doesn't come to council meetings. Everybody doesn't even watch the council meetings. But if we go into the communities that we serve and we represent, then we're giving people an opportunity to address us. And we get away from this thing where people say to us the only time they see us is every 4 years when we're running for re-election. Well, no, we're going to go into the community, and we're going to meet and have these town hall style meetings in different areas of the county. Now, I'm going to defend council. It's not council's responsibility to come to your house and grab you by your big toe and wake you up and drag you out of bed to come to that meeting. If we are coming into those communities and we're doing this twice a year and we're putting ourselves out there to meet with you, then that's your opportunity to come. You don't have to come down on the first Monday night or the third Tuesday night. We're coming into your community, so you can address us and ask us about the direction of the county, ask us different questions about what we're doing in county government. And so, again, we'll be getting that information out to you all as soon as possible. I look forward to it, and I know that the members of council look forward to it as well. With that being said, is there anything that any of the members of council might have that they want to share with the public? All right. Well, again, thank you all so much for being with us, and members of council. Thank you all again for your hard work and your dedication to this county. And at this time, I will entertain a motion to adjourn. Not everybody at one time.
No move, Mr. Chairman.
All right. So we have a motion to adjourn by Councilman Floyd. Is there a second?
Second.
All right. I have a second by Councilman Wilson. Are we ready for questions? All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right. Thank you all so much. We'll see you the first Monday night in October. Thank you all so much. Have a blessed evening.